In 2021, a government study revealed that internet service providers collect and sell shocking amounts of sensitive user data. So, do you believe you're safe because you use incognito mode or a VPN? If so, think again. Your DNS could be snitching on you, allowing for your internet service provider to see every website you visit. In the US and many other countries, ISPs can legally sell your browsing history to advertisers and data brokers. And no, a VPN won't fully protect you. That's why I consider this a privacy nightmare. ISPs have fought for the right to sell your data, so why trust them to protect it? In this video, I'll show you exactly what DNS is, how it exposes your online activity, and most importantly, how you can start reclaiming your online privacy today. DNS stands for Domain Name System, and its job is to translate website names into numerical values called IP addresses. Think of DNS as a phone book to the internet. When you type a website into a browser's address bar, DNS converts that name into an IP address. We need DNS because computers communicate with each other using IP addresses and not the domain names. And since humans aren't robots, at least not yet, it would be impossible for us to memorize the IP addresses for every website. And this is how DNS solves the issue. It bridges the communication gap between humans and computers. Let's say you want to visit example.com. You type it into your browser and hit enter. First, your device checks its local memory, or cache, to see if it already knows the IP address for example.com. If it does, your request gets sent straight there. But what if your device doesn't know the correct IP address? In that case, your device sends a DNS query to a special server called a recursive resolver. By default, this resolver usually belongs to your ISP. The resolver then contacts a root DNS server. Root servers don't know exactly where example.com is, but they point your query to the right top-level domain server, or TLD server. These are the servers responsible for extensions like .com, .net, .edu, and .org. Since you ask for example.com, the query heads to the .com TLD server. The TLD server doesn't know the IP address either, but it knows exactly which server does, and it's called the authoritative name server. Finally, your query reaches the authoritative server, which provides the actual IP address of example.com. This IP address is sent back to the resolver, which saves it in its cache for future use. Then the resolver sends it back to your device, which also caches the address temporarily, so next time you don't have to go through all these steps again. With the IP address found, your device sends your original request directly to example.com, and just like that, the website loads. Usually, this process is done in milliseconds. By now, you probably see the privacy risk in this process, and if not, take a closer look at the DNS resolver. Remember, if you're using default DNS settings, your request usually goes straight to your ISP's DNS resolver. And here is where the problem lies. These DNS queries are sent unencrypted, meaning your ISP can easily see and log every domain name you look up in plain text. Even worse, DNS requests often include extra details about your device, making it easier for your ISP or anyone else watching to identify you, even if you think you're anonymous on public Wi-Fi. When you use your ISP's default DNS resolver, you're at the mercy of your ISP, hoping they won't misuse or sell your data. Unfortunately, that trust has been broken before. And if that sounds paranoid, consider that there's concrete evidence of ISPs sharing browsing history, app usage, and even precise location data with advertisers, data brokers, and even government agencies. In fact, many ISPs have actively lobbied against privacy laws that would restrict this kind of data collection. According to a 2021 FTC staff report, the report identified several troubling data collection practices among several of the major ISPs. And the ISPs included were AT&T, Verizon Wireless, Charter Communications, Comcast, T-Mobile, and Google. I'm not saying all ISPs are shady or out to exploit your data, but you should be aware and take time to research what your ISP does with your browsing activity. Some providers are more transparent than others, and you can often find those details in their privacy policy. But if you want to protect yourself from ISP surveillance, a VPN alone isn't enough. A VPN, or virtual private network, encrypts your internet traffic and hides your IP address. But unless your VPN also handles DNS requests, your device still sends those lookups through your default DNS server, which is often your ISP. This is called a DNS leak. It means that even though your traffic is encrypted, your ISP can still see which websites you're visiting by watching the DNS queries. If you want to test for DNS leaks, try dnsleaktest.com. It'll show you which DNS servers your device is actually using and whether your VPN is doing its job. If you made it this far, consider dropping a like and subscribing to support the channel. But by now, you're probably wondering how to protect yourself from DNS leaks. Before we jump into the solutions, let me quickly explain why these methods I'm about to show you are actually secure. There are two main ways to encrypt your DNS requests: DNS over HTTPS, or DOH, and DNS over TLS, or DOT. Both methods prevent your ISP from seeing your DNS queries in plain text. DNS over HTTPS works by encrypting your DNS requests and sending them through the same secure channel your browser uses when you visit an HTTPS website. So when using DOH, the domain queries you make are no longer sent in plain text, making it a lot harder for your ISP to see which sites you're trying to visit. DNS over TLS works a bit differently. Instead of sending DNS requests through an HTTPS connection, it sends them directly over a TLS encrypted channel at the transport layer. TLS, or transport layer security, uses the same encryption technology used by HTTPS, but it's not limited to just websites. Now let's jump into three practical ways you can start using to protect yourself from DNS leaks today. If you're browsing online without a VPN, here's a quick way to significantly improve your privacy using Firefox's HTTPS only mode and a privacy-focused DNS resolver like Quad9. Quad9 is a respected nonprofit known for blocking threats and protecting users' privacy. Modern browsers like Firefox, Brave, and Chrome make enabling these privacy features simple. Here's how to set this up quickly in Firefox. First, we need to enable HTTPS only mode. To do this, we click on the hamburger menu icon in the top right corner, then select Settings. In the Settings search bar, type HTTPS. Near the top, you'll see HTTPS only mode. Click the bubble beside Enable HTTPS only mode in all windows. This ensures your browser always tries to connect securely to websites, protecting the content you view from your ISP. The next step is to set up encrypted DNS with Quad9. Open a new tab, go to quad9.net, and click More Options at the top. Scroll down and copy the link under DNS over HTTPS. Now return to Firefox settings. In the search bar, type DNS. Under Enable DNS over HTTPS, select Max Protection. Click the drop down under Choose Provider, select Custom, and paste the Quad9 URL you copied. And that's it. Now your Firefox browser sends DNS requests securely through Quad9's encrypted DNS servers. But here's a quick heads up. The method we just covered only protects DNS requests made within your browser. Apps like Discord, email clients, or Steam still rely on your system level DNS settings, so they won't be protected. But don't worry. The next two methods will address system wide protection. I recommend using a reputable privacy-focused VPN like Movad. Movad VPN encrypts all your traffic and automatically routes your DNS requests through their private, non-login DNS servers. This ensures your ISP can't see your DNS queries or track your online activity. Here's how to set it up. Go to Movad's website and create an account. Next, add credit to your account. It's about $6 per month. Download and install the Movad VPN app. Open the Movad app, log in, and select any server location from the list. If you really want full control and don't like relying on third-party DNS services, you can go one step further and create your own DNS server. A popular setup involves using a Raspberry Pi and a tool called Pi-hole, which blocks ads and trackers at the network level while acting as your private DNS resolver. Using Pi-hole is one of the most effective ways to take total control of your DNS requests, but it does take some time to set up. So instead of cramming all that into this video, I'll probably create a dedicated tutorial for it in the future. And yes, even though there's already hundreds of Raspberry Pi and Pi-hole tutorials out there, I'm probably going to still make one because honestly, I just want an excuse to do it. That's it for this one. Thanks for watching. Consider subscribing for more privacy-focused content. And as always, stay curious, stay aware, and let's keep fighting for our privacy. See you next time.